When we say innovation, I think we think something like betterment. So for me, it's really use cryptocurrencies and the blockchain to better the economic experience of the people, me included. What we are doing is really experimenting in new forms of approaching the money system. Today we have a privately issued currency, although if we go out and ask to somebody in the street, they will say that the money system is a government office, which is not. So every central bank in the world is just a consortium of the biggest high street banks of the nation. So it's really a private enterprise masked as a public service. So what we do, we say, well, the current money system is based on competition because it's debt at positive interest. We issue money that is debt-free, so it's pure credit. It's based on cooperation, and it will be owned by the community that use the currency system and not by a consortium, a cartel of private institutions like it happens today. We start from a system that is antisocial, foster the richer get richer kind of dynamic, okay? And there is nothing for anybody else, also regardless of social and environmental costs, okay? So what we do again, we reverse engineer it. It's a system that is based on fostering social relationship rather than hindering them, or you know, make them one-dimensional as the current money system does. So we really speak about multi-currency systems in the sense that we keep the current one, because it's stupid to try to kill what you cannot kill, because it's too big to face in a violent way. Since the current system is based on violence as a social control mechanism, we use math to circumvent the Goliath and to, you know, try to detach without using violence toward the opponent. We can really try to find ways to create and manage money from a user-based perspective, which takes into account the common sphere. Because the problem with the conventional system is that the game of debt positive interest, whereby your debt increases only with the amount of time that passes, it's anti-economic, and it's a game that drains resources from the common sphere and give them to what we call capital or conventional bank debt. The rules of the game in this case are playing with money as a common good. We are still understanding what it means. Actually, the definition of money as a common is simply to use something, you know, as a means of payment managed as a common good. And it never happened, at least in the digital era. Looking at big numbers of people participating in such kind of project, let's remember that the potential user base for PayNews is 120 million people. So actually, one quarter of the European population is defined at risk of poverty or poor. And it's super interesting to see that when they switch on the money concept, they really see the importance of having a say, because it's on their wallet. But as I said, the 20 euro that you take out from your wallet are not yours. This is property of the ECB. What happens when the money is really yours? We can just continue to say that it's wrong, or start to build up the alternative because we have the technical capabilities to do so today. Ideally, the dream would be that everybody, every single individual is endowed with the power to issue currency. So the bank will be redundant at some point. Then after that point, we will be in Star Trek no money society. Let's put it that way. I guess that from here to there, we will have the sort of non-revolution that we had with the email, because the post office didn't close. Well, actually, it became a bank. So maybe if we have a new form of issuing money, which is not only commercial bank-based, banks, we will find ways to increase their portfolio and offer different services. And maybe, they will become something that it's more public oriented than profit money making oriented.